From time to time, a section of rail needs repair. But that doesn't mean the whole line needs replacement. The same way being proud of your history doesn't mean you're stuck in the past. No, we're not stuck. We hear the whistle blowing and we're inspired. Inspired by the legacy of the people who transformed this terrain into a rail yard that supplied America with the ore needed to win world wars. We're inspired by our unshakable identity, hanging tight, like David facing down Goliaths. And we're moved by stories of our community's kindness. No matter who needs help, neighbors pitch in and get the job done. Hushed and humbled are more at play than pontification. But don't for one second think that means Proctor is a simple small town. It was built as a company town, and it continues down the tracks of time. And this rail revival is our destination.
Well, good evening, everyone, and welcome to Rails Television. Welcome to the St. Luke's Hockey and Event Center. And tonight's main event is the Section 7 Single-A Boys High School Hockey Tournament. Tonight, the Rails of Proctor take on the Storm of North Shore. Hi, everyone. Steve Chizerski with you on a midweek day as we bring you tournament hockey. And, yes, a surprise voice here. And I got a call last night from Dave Ryles. He said some help was needed. I said I haven't done anything for my school in 51 years since I graduated. And so this is a good time to maybe give back a little bit and provide some hockey play-by-play tonight. It's the Rails take on the Storm in tournament hockey. And tournament time, always a very, very special time as we begin the road to the state high school hockey tournament with the sport in the state of hockey in the state of Minnesota. Well, these two teams met 12 days ago, and it was a one-sided game. The Rails won 8-0. They won easily. They had 57 shots on net versus 15 from the Storm, and they had goal scores from Brecklin Ross. Austin Bryan scored. Mina Hines scored. Austin Bryant scored again, and he also scored again. He had a hat trick that night. Also, Meinahein had a pair of goals, and Boysen scored, Towers scored, and Tanner Ross had 5 assists in that game. They had their way, and that was 12 days ago, and I'm wondering if one team's got a short memory and the other one is trying to remember so they don't forget and maybe do some things different here tonight. I got the late notice last night, did not have time to talk to the two coaches. I would have loved to have done that, but I did do some research and find out a little bit about these two teams. And if you look at the Rails, they are 18-7 coming in. They score about 3.9 goals per game. They don't give much over 2 per game, while North Shore had a real nice season at 12 wins, 10 losses, and 3 ties, 2.96 goals per game, so let's call it 3. They give up about 3.2. If you look at special teams play, the Rails power play at about 15%, their penalty kill, and these things are important at playoff time, roughly if you round it up to 80%, which is pretty good. It's more average than it is real good. And then you've got North Shore, 13.8, so we'll round that up to 14% of the power play. Their penalty kill is very good at 87.5%. Rails have some goal scorers. They have some goal scorers. They've got the very fine defenseman, Pavlovich, who has 27 assists to go with his 5 goals on the season. And they are a team that can score. They are a team that can score. They are mindful of the team I followed all winter, St. Scholastica. The Saints could put the puck away. The Rails can do it as well. So we get these two teams tonight. And again, it's a rematch. And you wonder what's going to happen. Is it going to be another one-sided game? The Storm, they don't want it to be. Sean Lundgren is their head coach, and he's a man who he's got quite a hockey background. You go back to Fairbanks, Alaska, where he's in their Hockey Hall of Fame for his contributions to competitive hockey in that area. And from what I understand, talking with Dave Ryles, he hails from Two Harbors originally, and he's done a nice job with the Storm in his few years there. And then, of course, right here with the hometown Rails, Jeff Laspy, an alum, and he's got the Rails going going in a great direction as well. Two fine goaltenders tonight. One is headed to Division I hockey, and that would be the Rails' A.J. Reilts. And his goals against, not much over two. He's got a trio of shutouts on the year. And the young man for the North Shore Storm is Zach Bentler. And Bentler has done some fine net mining of his own this season. And we look at Bentler. He's got 10 wins. He's 2.92 goals against and a save percentage of 91%. And Ryle's coming in as the lights go down on my notes here. And we're going to get the opening for tonight's hockey game. So let's take you down to the ice. And I'm sure we'll get the voice of Mr. Fleischer, Mark Fleischer.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome your Proctor Rails. Welcome the Storm from North Shore. Good evening, hockey fans, and welcome to the St. Luke Sports and Events Center for tonight's Section 7A quarterfinal game that features the Storm from North Shore against the Proctor Rails. Let's meet the starters for tonight's contest, starting with the team that'll be the visitors on the scoreboard, the Storm from North Shore. Starting in goal, wearing number 33, Zach Bentler. On defense, wearing number 4, Tucker Cook. Also on defense, number 12, Jacob Carpenter. One of the wings tonight, wearing number 9, Braylon Hoff. The other wing, wearing number 18, Andrew Weirman. And starting at center, wearing number 29, Jake Stadler. The assistant coaches are Tom Johnson and Andy Fellow. The head coach of the North Shore Storm is Sean Lundgren. The starting lineup for your Proctor Rails. Your goaltender tonight, he is also one of your captains. He's a senior wearing number 33, A.J. Reilts. On defense, he is also a senior and one of your captains, wearing number 12, Nolan Oakstead. Another one of your captains, he's a senior wearing number 27, Carson Pavlovich. At a wing, you've got a senior that wears number 20, Wyatt Meinehein. Your other wing is a sophomore who wears number 8, Brecken Ross. And your starting center is a senior that wears number 19, Dylan Davidson. The assistant coaches for Proctor are Corey Ward, Kevin Danielson, Nate Regas, and Andy Morin. Your head coach is Jeff Laspy.
Ladies and gentlemen, to honor America and as a show of respect to the men and women who have given their lives in preserving freedom in this country and throughout the world. We ask that you now rise, if you are able, and remove your hats for the playing of the national anthem. You're at today's contest, that these are kids. This is a game. Parents should cheer for everyone and be role models at all times. Remember, the officials and coaches are human. Thank you for your support of the athletes, coaches, and officials. Enjoy today's contest.
Tonight's officials have been assigned by the Minnesota State High School League and Section 7. Your referees are Kevin Morrison and Brett Klizalski. Your linesman tonight is Sam Van Loon.
Well, a very nice pregame festivity tonight as we get ready for the Section 7 Single-A quarterfinal playoff game tonight, the Rails of the Storm. And we are live tonight on Rails TV right here from the St. Luke's Hockey and Event Center. Kevin Morrison and Brett Klizalski, a couple of very familiar names from area sports, and they work more than one sport and have been great officials in this area for a long, long time and have both worked at a higher level as well. The Rails and A.J. Riles, they will defend it on our right and go from right to left here in the opening period. And, of course, the Storm and their netminder, Zach Bentler, at our left in period number one as we get set to play tournament hockey from St. Luke's Hockey and Event Center. Look down below and see Mark Fleischer, one of the great voices in the area, public address announcer. That's a class act to begin with. I like the Rails all white with the green trim. They had their warm-ups, and it was the forest green. Looked very similar to the black on the ice. And I thought, oh, no, this is going to be a tough one. But they took the warm-ups off, and we've got white, we've got black, and we're getting ready to go. They've got the Davidson line, Dylan Davidson out there to face off in the Storm. They've got Seth Stadler, their big scorer, on. Here we go into the zone on the left, posing to the net. They score! And it's already a 1-0 hockey game. And we are 12 seconds, 13 seconds in. Well, that happened right away. Meinerhein, Wyatt Meinerhein, scores for the third time in four periods against this team. Davidson winning that draw. And whoever made the pass to Meinerhein will pick up assist here. You can do it quicker, but not real easily.
It's his first goal of the tournament, number 20, Wyatt Meinerhein. He got an assist on the goal from number 12, Nolan Oakstead, and number 27, Carson Pavlovich. That's Meinerhein from...
getting his 30th assist, I believe, in the season. If it's not 30, it's 28. My memory isn't as good as it was 51 years ago. Play is in the rail zone at our right. Section 7 playoff hockey over on the far side boards being kept in from the point by the defenseman Tikkanen. Back to the behind, trying to center to the front, broken up by Pavlovich, and it'll be taken back into behind the net. Out to center, the Rails come. They try to make the pass ahead, blocked back into the rail zone, played by the Rails' Nolan Oakstead. Three captains on the ice with the game opening line and the two defensemen here tonight. Rails back at their own blue line on an intercept. Mahanalot gave it to his partner, sent ahead up the right side by Cooper Johnson. That goes deep into the zone, an angle shot, and it comes right through to the near side and all the way out to center and back into the rail zone. Going back to get it is Anila. A couple of Coopers on defense, Johnson and Anila. Now on the left, out to neutral. That one will go the distance. We'll get icing called on the rails. Rails have scored 97 goals in 25 games. That's nearly four a game, three shy of that. Given up just a total of 52. Visitors have scored 74 this season in 25 games. And that nearly a three-goal average. When the draw comes outside the blue line, and they'll send it back in. Cam Peterson will for North Shore. Picked up back into behind by Anila. Anila to his left on the pass of the backside of the intended receiver. And that was Austin Bryant. Now the rails come rink wide with a pass out to center. Batted back the other way. And the rails getting the puck back. Ahead on the right into the zone. Play by the rails and Anila working the far side boards. Tries to put it to the front. That'll deflect into the slot. And taken by North Shore on the pass out to center. That neutralized. The rails will get possession into their own zone. Now work by the defenseman, Cooper Johnson. Johnson on the far boards being forechecked by Stadler. They'll come long on a diagonal pass. It's taken into the circle, closing to the net, a backhander, and that's sent wide through to the far side by Tanner Ross. Back to the right point, played to the left side. Quick shot and a good save made out the blocker of Bentler, and they'll play it on the near side corner into the circle. Being played towards the slot area. Now up the slot, skated out to center. They'll play it ahead. North Shore will on the pass into the zone. Delayed offside call. They'll take up. Rails will get possession of the puck played by Oaksted. He'll give it across on the right. Now the rails ahead on the right and the long shot into the zone by Pavlovich. And we'll get a whistle. We'll get a faceoff at that. Trying to get ourselves acclimated here tonight. Faceoff outside the blue line of the North Shore Storm zone. And now they're going to move that faceoff to the center circle. They've got Stadler on. And Stadler's going to face off with the rails and Ethan Carter. My understanding is North Shore will play about seven forwards tonight and three defensemen, and in no particular order. Rails into the zone on the far side, trying to get a shot off, was Boysen around to the near side boards, played on the back wall, now side of the net, over to the near boards, and the bank pass along the boards, kept in from the left point by the stick of Anila. That stuck aside by Bentler, back into behind North Shore, giving it around to the near side wing. 1-0 Rails, a goal 12 seconds in. It actually was 12. They let that clock run an extra second, so officially have to say 13 seconds in. Over on the far boards, Johnson with a shot, and that's saved by Bentler over to the near boards. They'll bring it ahead. Bentler, we understand, was not at his best the first time around. He gave up 8 goals, and that's not who he is. His goals against is under 3. That was just 12 days ago. Rails have won 3 of their last 4 coming into the playoffs. Bentler, good-sized netminder, face-off at his right. Althaus, their second leading goal getter, is on to face-off, and he draws it off along with Davidson, Dylan Davidson. On the pass ahead, stepping up to the right point and taking a shot that's wide of the mark. That comes around to the near wing. Back out to neutral. No, it's kept in the zone. Played across ice. Now North Shore trying to give it ahead of the far wing. Played off the boards. Into the circle. Handling is Ross, and that's Breckenwall. Ross, and that's sent wide from atop the far circle. There's a shot taken. That's back into behind the net. Now the fire to the front. Knocked down. Good check in front with Lucas, rather not Lilla, but rather Braylon Hoff. Hoff taking down one of the rails in the slot. North Shore in its own zone, bouncing puck, trying to come out to neutral. Cole Anderson, Anderson along the far side. Puck will get away from him into the corner. Rails go back to get it with Oaksted. And Oaksted will stick handle. The puck gets away from him out to neutral, put right back into the zone by Weirman. Weirman of North Shore. Pavlovich back to the behind. He'll give it to the far wing. Ahead and out to neutral ice. On the right, bump down on the far wing boards. And I think Davidson, he's slow in getting up. I think it's Davidson. It's 19. And I don't see any arms going up. I don't see any penalties. But he took a bump on the far side, got knocked down face first. I was thinking about the changes since I watched the Rails play last, and that was a long time ago. That was in high school, and they were playing 15-minute periods back then. And power plays were only a minute and a half. Think about that. Stadler facing off with Tanner Ross. On the Rails, back into behind with Cooper Johnson to his right, carries ahead of the wing, passes out to center, too long, picked off, sent back the other way by the stick of Carpenter from North Shore, handled by Riles, taking it back into behind the net by Anila. Here's Anila's pass up the middle, Tanner Ross, Ross passing to the right, into the zone on the right wing, working the far side, back into behind the net is Griswold, and he'll get it back to the left point, and it's out to neutral ice as it's deflected back into the Rails end, and they'll go back can get it with Cooper Johnson. Now Johnson will bank it off the wall ahead for Bryant, Austin Bryant, and that one from neutral sent into the far corner. Cooper Johnson will handle for Proctor. 1-0 Rails here in the early going, 11:35, just into this first period. Pass, he wanted to go on an angle up the right wing, was blocked in the slot. We've got a whistle, we'll get a hand pass called, and we'll face it up, and I think outside the blue line. Benches are directly across from us. Great view. Beautiful, beautiful facility. My second time in here, actually. They'll take it all the way down to the other side, so the hand pass called against the Rails. Ethan Carter is on. Carter with Althaus. Aiden Althaus. And a tie-up in the face-off circle. The battle, the puck comes free, bang to the boards, back to the right point. Pavlovich with a shot, that'll go through. Near corner, comes up the wall, pinching in on the near side. It was Oaksted. Now banged out to neutral ice up the near wing, skittering on edge, going back. Pavlovich trying to get back there as well as Cade Norman for the shore. Back to the right point, there's a shot. That one deflected off the glass, back into behind. From the end, we're trying to send it to the front, banged right through the goal mouth to the far corner. Now headed out to center ice. All the way down on the right wing, we'll get icing called on the Rails. Not a real flow yet here in the first period of this playoff game. Jake Stadler on to face off for North Shore. 18 goals on the season, 41 points for his North Shore team. On the draw, the North Shore controls. There's a drive, and that one hits glass back at a behind. Might have been deflected by Riles. Out to center ice on the near wing. Played towards the line. Broken up there by Cooper Johnson. He'll turn away from the check. Here's Johnson backing into his end, giving it across to Anila. Cooper Anila on a pass to the near wing. Sent ahead to the blue line. Brought into the zone. Here's Ross. Brecken Ross losing it on a check. And the pass now rink wide. Following the puck into the zone, unable to get his stick on it. On the receiving end, it was Hoff, and the Rails take over. Cooper Johnson to the far side of the pass for Ross. Skating in on the left, keeping it in the zone is Carpenter. It's back into behind, picked up by North Shore, trying to center it off the back wall. Fanning, Rails get a hold of it. They'll reverse it near side, picked up by Cooper Johnson. Now Johnson's pass to the line, but not out. And apparently it did come out. They brought it back in immediately for an offside. Did not look to be out. Tonight's hockey broadcast brought to you by Reed Rails Endowment for Academics, Arts, and Athletic Development. Also Irving Community Club, Pulling for Kids, and Tamarack Building Supplies, Highway 53 in Hermantown. Rails with possession on the pass out attempt. That one's knocked down at the blue line by the stick of Weirman. Now brought in by the Rails into the far circle to the back wall. Bryant going after it along with one of the Storm. Weirman trying to play it. He'll put it out to neutral and taking over the defense. Pavlovich with a pass up the near side into the zone on the left. Tanner Ross tipping it. He'll go to his own pass into the corner and the back wall sends it around to the far side for Austin Bryant. Feeds it back to the right wing. Pavlo sending it down low. Goes back into behind the goal. They dig away back behind the net. And coming up with it is Jacob Carpenter. He'll give it ahead on the left, trying to clear it out of the zone is Wehrman. And it'll come over to the near side ice. We'll play it ahead along the near side. That for Ross, or rather for Bryant. Now back inside the rail zone. The rail defense skating it to center. Terry Dunbar will join us during the first intermission. They'll close through the circle, turning, firing, right on. Tanner Ross puts a wicked shot on, and the save made by Bettler. He'll keep it. We'll get a face-off at his right. Somebody told me that when Ross and Bryant are moving the puck, they can be absolutely electric. Ethan Carter's unit is back out there. He's got Kellen Towers on one wing and Blaine Boysen on the other. Battle on the backboards. Cam Peterson for North Shore in behind the net. Stadler. Stadler turning away from the check attempt by Carter. Now he's picked up by another rail. Getting a hold of it. They'll rink wide it out to center, and that'll go for icing on North Shore. 1-0 the score. Here in the opening period, shots at 4-2 in favor of the Rails. They got on the board just 13 seconds in. On the tally from Meinahein, and assisting him, Oakstead and Pavlovic. They drop it and they blow the whistle. Kevin Morrison blowing the whistle. He's working with Brett Klazowski. I give Brett a hard time. You usually see one call in every game that you haven't seen for quite some time. And we'll wait for that one to happen tonight and try to address it. Now to center, the Storm to the blue line. Held up there, shy of the blue line. Stadler has it jammed off a stick up the near side. Pursuing it for the rails is Boysen, pair of 17s. Boysen going into the corner with Peterson and back into behind. Boysen holds up. We've got a whistle. We're going to get a penalty. And the rails will be shorthanded on a cross check. I'm sorry, the Shore will be shorthanded on a cross check. Knocked down on that cross check was Ethan Carter. And Stadler is going to go. Time of the penalty is 8:32. Rail's power play is on. Their power play at about 15%. Face off one back to the blue line. Tanner Ross giving to the right to Pavlovic. Over to the far side circle. Into the slot. Comes off a rail. There's an angle shot down low. That was blocked and played to the near side. Now Tanner Ross on the near board. Center blue line to Pavlovic. His pass over to the flopper. To the slot right on. Rebound. And that's tipped wide back into behind. That one off the stick of Austin Bryant. And it's cleared down the near wing and back into the rail zone. Riles back into behind the net. He'll save it for Pavlovic. And they'll play it around the near side. Now a rink wide pass, backing, turning around, getting to the puck that got away from him, but one of the North Shore Storm gets there first, and we're going to get what we're going to get. I think a delayed offside. If it is that, it's a very delayed call. Face off outside the blue line on the far wing. On the draw, comes back into the rail zone. Power play hockey for Proctor. Minute 15 remaining. 1-0 they lead here in the first period. Pavlovich's pass ahead on the left, brought into the zone by Meinahein. Shoots, he scores! Oh, what a beauty! That was all snipe. That was all snipe from the near circle. He caught the elbow. He was shooting upper near corner. At the right where the pipe comes together, he found a hole there. And Meinahein scores. And it's 2-0 Rails. It's a power play goal. Time of the goal is 9:30.
Power play goal for Proctor. His second goal of the hockey game. Number 20, Wyatt Meinahein. He got an assist on the goal from number 27, Carson Pavlovich, and number 33, A.J. Riles.
Riles picks up an assist. He had one the first time these two teams met. Goaltender Riles. Now the far circle shot to the net, steered aside by Bettler on the shot taken by Towers. 2-0. Rails Meinheim with a pair of goals in this game. Sent back to the right point. There's a shot for the point. That was wide back into behind. Cooper Johnson with a shot on the backboard being played by Boysen. Boysen puts it to the slot. A shot. And that one is deflected wide to the near side. Now left point with a shot. That one knocked down in front. Comes to the top of the near circle. Shot right on. That's two or three saves in a row. And Antla's had two of those. Antla will keep it in. Along the near wall, they'll get hold of it. Stadler's pass out to neutral to the blue line, broken up there. Trying to bring it in was Norman. They'll send it in deep and change. In behind the goal, Antla's pass to the near boards. He's hoping someone will get there. Rails were making some changes of their own. Now throw him back into behind the goal by the Storm, over to the far corner. Give it ahead on the boards. Sent ahead, but not out. Boysen. It's tipped out to neutral. Check over on the far side. Throwing the weight around was Parmeter. It's kept in. And the Rails will take it, a play it, and they'll move it and then retreat, turning, putting it out to neutral, Meinheim. And on a second attempt, as it came back in, they get the puck out to neutral ice, and the Storm will take and throw it right back in, down through the near corner. Cooper Johnson sends it around to the right. On the Rails, they'll put it out to neutral ice, and it comes right back inside the blue line, trying to handle as Anderson. For the Storm, high slot, Meinheim for the Rails, gives it ahead on the left, and then running into a check and losing the puck was Dylan Davidson. From neutral ice, thrown back in by Bracken Ross. Rails in the offensive zone with a 2-all lead on a pair of Meinheim goals, including a power play effort. Another long shot in. That one scooped up off the ice by Zach Bentler. We'll get a faceoff in the Storm end. 5:22 remaining in the first. And there is no score. There is a 2-0 score here in the opening period. Tonight's hockey game brought to you by Heritage Window and Door in Superior, Wisconsin. Wittes Trailer Sales and Esco, and also Stream Dudes, as well as Great Lakes Office Solutions. Pavlovich to the left point. Shot taken. It's blocked from the stick of Oaksted. Oaksted stepping up along the near boards. Sent towards the corner by the Rails and Giswold. He'll play it out the near wing. Fires a pass back. A diagonal pass that comes out to center. Pavlovich, and he'll be checked. Puck at the blue line. Comes ahead of the near wing. Rails getting knocked around a little bit just in an effort to get to the puck outside at neutral ice. The Storm take and put it through the defenseman's leg to the legs of Oaksted deep into the zone and back into behind the net. Now Oaksted will give it around to the right. It's moved ahead along the far boards by the Rails. Griswold and played back beneath the circle. Pavlovich's pass to the near side carried in on the left. Bryant with a shot right on. He's got a little mustard on it, a little zip. I was looking at the size of the Rails. They've got some players who are not real big, but they've got to be strong. Terry Dunbar, former Rail goaltender, will join us during the first intermission. Section 7 single-A playoff hockey with the Rails leading 2-0 on a pair of Meinheim goals. They draw it off of the circle, pretty good standoff, and then finally pulled free, sent cross rink out at center with the Storm, getting there Cooper Johnson. Along the far boards, turned around. Jacob Carpenter, it comes deep into the Storm man, played near corner by Tikkanen. He'll send it around the far side. There's Carpenter again, jams it ahead out to neutral through Boysen. And they'll get it and bring it in with Norman. Now Norman will take a shot. Gloved by Riles. He'll keep it. We'll get a faceoff. Might have been high. 4 minutes left in the period. Shots at 13-3. First time around, they were 57-15 12 days ago. They'll do that faceoff over again. Had a lot of standoffs on the faceoff tonight. Rails with Carter, and he'll draw it off along with Althaus, Aiden Althaus. On the faceoff, one to the corner, sent around to the near side, all the way around the boards, trying to come out on the left. As Towers his pass, shy of the blue line, out to neutral. We've got a man trapped in the zone. Everybody gets onside. North Shore with a pass out. Partial fan on that pass out. Getting to Tikkanen. Skates it to his right. He'll send it in, and they're offside on the far wing. Not a lot of flow. But two goals for Proctor. one of them, the first one coming 13 seconds in. Rails Hockey and Rails TV brought to you by Rob and Barb Schaller Charitable Foundation, Troy Service Center, right there on Main Street in Proctor, right at the lights. Audiology Concepts, Superior, Duluth, Grand Rapids, Forest Lake, Cambridge, Edina, and Burnsville. Pass it neutral for Monahine in on the right. Here's Brecken Ross. Ross being checked, taking it back, get it behind. Good play by Tucker Cook, the defenseman. On the near boards, near corner, 3:18 remaining of the period. Rails trying to come to the front with Meinahine. It's played back into behind the net. Over to the far side, Peterson. He's in the far corner for North Shore. Inboard pass around to the near wing. Banged off the glass out to center. Knocked down by the glove hand of Oakstead. He'll carry in and offside on the right is the Royals' Dylan Davidson. Not the crowd I was expecting tonight. Why I had any reason to expect anything other than it is playoff hockey. And I did see signage when I came in for overflow parking. Not necessarily needed. Not a poor crowd by any means, but they've got Altos on drawing off along with Tanner Ross. And they chase Ross. After a faulty draw, and in comes Austin Bryant. Now Bryant wins the faceoff, and Tanner Ross will get the puck. Sends it back to the far side to Anilas. Pass ahead on the right. Over to the near wing. Storm trying to get the puck outside. They do to neutral and one-on-one, but unable to control the puck was Cade Norman. It's back outside to neutral ice. Battle is at neutral ice on the left, fed ahead, Norman down the slot, closing, sends it wide of the mark. It'll be played back into behind around to the near side. Rails get control, they give it away. Kept in, put to the corner by Althaus. Tanner Ross had it for a moment, put back into behind, tried to give it to the front. Broken up of the rails, and they'll clear it out to neutral up the near side. Back into his own zone, making that pass was Carpenter. It's over on the far side, just inside the blue line. Outside to neutral ice, and the Rails back at their own line. Now the Rails and Anna level the pass on the left. Broken up. Back out to neutral. Long shot into the zone by Gavin Davidson. They'll play it over on the far wing boards. Kept in by the Rails and Griswold. Now out to neutral ice. And that loose puck picked up by the Rails. And sent long into the zone. 1:50 remaining here in the period. 2-0 Rails in the first period of play. Long shot in, and A.J. Riles leaves the blocker and turn that aside on the long shot in by Cole Anderson over to the near wing. Played by the defenseman, Oakstead, put it around and behind. Up the near side, and then sent right back into the rail's end. Pavlovich, Mankin, Eastgate, he's beautiful to watch. In the rail zone being played. Put back into behind. Rails and Nolan Oakstead over to the far side. Trying to move it ahead is Boysen. He'll put it out to neutral. They'll turn it back the other way. North Shore to the blue line and out. Now carried in, sent towards the net. Less than a minute remaining of the period. And the puck to the net by Ethan Meeks. We'll get a whistle. We'll get a faceoff. Full slate tonight of single-A games. Should the Rails win tonight, they will in all likelihood on Saturday night play Hermantown. That would be at Hermantown. Davidson out to face off with Stadler. One to the far boards with a shot, and that's deflected out. Quick glove just off the ice by goaltender A.J. Riles. A.J.'s had a wonderful senior year. 13-4 on the season, save percentage of nearly 95%, and a goals against of just above two. Brenda Toxin goaltending with Terry Dunbar, and that'll be during the second intermission. Quite a trail of goaltenders here at Proctor High. I go all the way back to my time in high school here, 51 years ago. 51, 52, what is it? Class of 72. So I guess that would be 52 years ago this spring. And I go back to F. Borg, Gary Warren, who had to be one of the nicest guys to ever ride the Munger school bus, and also Billy Moan. Billy was a year or so behind me. Drott comes back to the left point, played to the right side. Cooper Johnson with a shot. That one altered by the stick of Rockin' Ross, and they put a puck right on. Bentler making the save. We got a little bit of pushing and shoving, but that's not going to go very far. We're down to 37 seconds here in the period. Got basketball on the air tonight, too. My understanding is the Proctor Girls High School team is playing tonight. North Shore controlling off the draw, being played by Althaus on the pass on the left. Stadler will feed it, tried to feed it ahead on the left from Jennifer Anderson, broken up by the rails, and it's put deep in. Played par circle, tried to give it ahead, kept in by Davidson, wanting to pull it ahead and go to the net with it. It's loose to the front. Where is it? The goaltender, Bentler, has got it. Meinheim was in front. He was looking for it. He's looking for a hat trick here in the first period. Could not quite get the puck to him, but Davidson sure tried. 13 seconds in, and then a little bit later, 9:30, Meinheim with two goals, the second being a power play goal, and that is the difference right now. Now North Shore trying to come out, 10 seconds left of the period. That puck will go through bodies and sticks all the way down the ice, played by Riles, taken to back, it'll be high by Anila. Anila gives it ahead of the right wing. Rails trying to quickly come out, and the horn sounds, and that will end the opening period of play. Here from the St. Luke's Hockey and Events Center, it's 2-0 Rails at the end of one period. We're going to go to break. We'll come back with our first intermission here on Rails TV. We're back at the St. Luke's Hockey and Events Center. Steve Chizerski with you, a surprise voice, I'm sure, here on a Tuesday night. And actually, I got a call last night, and someone said to me, you haven't done a doggone thing for your school for the 51, 52 years since you've been here. We don't even know if you did anything when you were here. And so we're going to ask you to do the hockey game tomorrow night. And so here I am, and happy to do it, and that's for sure. And that's something I would gladly do again in the future. Rails lead 2-0, couple of goals from a wonderful hockey player by the name of Wyatt Meinheim. He got his Rails on the board 13 seconds in and then did it again about 9 minutes later on a power play. And shots in the first period, 15-5 in the Rails' favor. And again, it was only 12 days ago when the Rails won 8-0 here on this same home ice and outshot North Shore by a 57-15 margin in that game. So a little bit of difference between the two teams, maybe a little bit in the schedule they play. With that said, North Shore has had a fine season. Don't count them out. We've got two periods to play. Terry Dunbar joins me. He's a former Rail as well. I don't think you go back 51 or 52 years. What? How many years? How many years have you been out?
It's not far off. It's kind of fun because I was just talking to a former teammate of mine, Jesse Hoffbauer, and this is the highest win total the Rails have had since we played back in 97.
Wow.
So really, really successful season. The staff has put together an outstanding summer program. I'm at the rink quite a bit, so I get a chance to, you know, pop my head in once in a while, run a skate or two, and they've done just an exceptional job with that summer piece, and it's showing up here during the season.
Terry, what would you have given a play in this facility? Isn't this incredible?
You know what? It's kind of... it's awesome. I'm not going to lie. In the net, I'd rather be at the old barn. Everyone hated to go in there. And you know, you always had that little advantage of just knowing. You see guys show up with the turtlenecks pulled up to their ears, and we were used to it. So it was kind of an advantage, and, you know, it showed up in the results. We didn't lose a home game that year. We made the tournament, and always had a lot of success in that building. So I hated to see it go, but I'm not going to lie, coaching, this is the best of all times. It's 52 degrees in here every day, and weather's always nice.
Yeah, you were saying that people didn't want to come into your building back in that day. And in this day, the present players might not want to go back and come back into it either.
You know what? I'm not going to lie. I don't miss it when you're, you know, Tuesday practice in February. But, you know, that was a special place, and it's cool they repurposed the facility. I've been in there
yes.
a couple of times with my little guys, you know, got turf out of the old Gophers football stadium, and they did such a job repurposing that thing to be useful for all athletics.
Well, this hockey team, as you said, having a record number of wins going back to your year in 97, and that being incredible in itself. What do you see this hockey team as being? What are they all about?
You know, the one thing that has been a really evident change for me is just the culture of the group. You know, years past, my opinion, which may not be the most popular, I think some of our high-end kids were maybe not the best kids. And I'm not trying to speak ill of anybody, but I will say A.J. Riles, Carson Pavlovich, some of these kids, they're just exceptional leaders. They're 4.0 students. How much they've done. I've got a couple of kids playing on the Squared A team. They've come and jumped on the bench and been a part of their season. These kids actually care about them, and I think it's because of who they are as human beings. You know, catching a fair amount of the games this year, you just see a commitment to blocking shots on the right night when you know you're going to need it. A lot of the undisciplined penalties have gone by the wayside. I mean, I went and watched section quarter at Denfeld when I first moved home from Texas in maybe 2017, something like that. And I was almost sad I brought my kids, because you saw the game unravel and then here comes the cross checks and all of that is gone. And, you know, now these kids, they know who their favorite player is. My kids ask me, are the Rails playing today? And that just wasn't the case 5 years ago. So it's really a tip of the cap to the kids in the jerseys and the staff for creating that environment. You do see a rejuvenation of things here. And, you know, we've got some really, really promising things happening at the youth level. The PVA team is exceptional. That's a really, really solid group. They've been ranked number one for a large chunk of the season. Good things coming.
Goaltending. You were a goalie here, very successful goaltender, and one of the reasons your team is so successful, it's always been a trademark, it seems, at this school. I go back to my days of being in school, and just before me was Ev Borg, then it was Gary Warren, and then it was Billy Moen, and then still others followed. What is it about goaltending here? I've been thinking back then, it's because, being quite honest, they saw a lot of shots, so they made a lot of saves, but they were still very talented at what they did.
No doubt, and I think you look at having, you know, a co-op with the Twig Youth Association is also really important, because you don't layer out. You're really filling goaltenders across how many different teams now, because you've got a segregated youth association there. And then when they merge together in peewees, you're usually dealing with tandems that can play. You know, the guys I played with during high school, Adam Leonzel was an absolute rock star. Corey Lonke, just younger than me, played at St. Scholastica. It's been, I think that's a huge piece of it. You know, secondly, at least these days, we don't really urge them to get in the net too soon. You know, watching my little guys grow up, you see kids that I'm the goalie when they're seven. I don't think I started playing full-time goalie till I was 10. And I think there's just an advantage for playing out. I mean, A.J. Routes is a good example. As late as a Bantam A, he was playing games out on the nights when Vinny Verville was in the net. And, you know, my nephew's a peewee. He's doing that right now as well. And you can't do that every association, but we can afford it. And I think it ups the skating and reading of the play. And you know, it's yielded some pretty good results.
The other thing I've noticed, too, is there are rails who played high school hockey here and are still involved in the game today, even outside the area. They move away, but yourself being an example, Corey Lonke being an example, and I'm sure there are others as well.
Yeah, it's, you know, it's a fight that I wanted to fight when I first came back. I took a player coaching development role on our board, and, you know, there's a lot of, you know, old school thinking, and dads want to coach hockey, of course. They know best, right? I'm guilty of it myself. But if you don't develop coaches as well, it's a problem. And right now, we've had so much success with helping develop our coaches in that PUEA, PUEB, Bantam A, Bantam B level. They're now kind of going out into the world. And, you know, A.J. Ryle's a good example. You know, I've worked with A.J. for a few years for my full-time job with Next Level Hockey. Guy who drafts him is Taylor Shaw, who coached here as a volunteer goalie coach for our association while he's a student at UMD, and has worked his way up through the 3HL in Gillette into Kenai as a head coach now. And a draft pick doesn't happen if you don't grow that coach here first. Another kid named Alex Gilbert was a PUEB coach here last year. He's in the 3HL with New Mexico now. You know, Corey Lonke was an assistant at Minnesota State last year. Chris Lonke, scouting director in Cedar Rapids and Minot. These guys are everywhere, and it's because we've kind of turned them loose. You know, Chris was my PUEA coach, and I'm sure he wouldn't tell you he was a perfect guy at that age. Nobody is going to be at that age, but
I was.
I'm not sure you were. But, you know, the rest of us have to take some lumps at that age, and, you know, for the families to trust these guys to find their way. And, you know, really, it's not great for the kids to have a dad coaching them. I don't think a lot of people have a real understanding of what that's like when dad's coach and you're 14. Your buddies are getting on top of you, right? And so remove that. And let's keep the culture here as positive as possible.
I want to ask you something about goaltending. And as you know, I've worked with the Saints Scholastica team broadcasting the last 19 years, actually. So I've seen goaltending over the years, and long before that, the prevalence of the glove, how it's used today. I'm guessing 75-80% of the saves are made with the glove, whether the puck's on the ice or not. I watched Augsburg goaltender Samuel Vilatelka last weekend. I saw him use his stick to stop more pucks than I'd seen probably all season combined, but every other goal he's using that glove, it's prevalent in stopping the puck.
Yeah, you know, with AJ, especially coming through youth hockey, he wanted to grab everything, and like Sammy is a good example. Like, just watching him, I think he's the best in that I've seen at the D3 yep. level. I mean, 6 shutouts and 11 starts last year, and he followed up with a big year this year. But watching him let the puck find him, and, you know, not being afraid to let that thing hit you right in the guts and let it stick instead of having to go grab it. I mean, I still can't do it. I'm playing 40 and over beer league. But I'm really impressed with guys that can track pucks. You see the crown of their helmet, watch it hit them right in the logo. And, you know, something that's really undervalued in goaltending. How your part to be a hockey player and help your team is game management. And, you know, giving Coach Laspy all the matchups he wants in a home game like this, that's AJ's goal, come in here and freeze as many pucks as possible. How many whistles can I get tonight? Want the puck. So it's a little bit different mindset than when I was coming through. You were just fending off and looking for the next one. Now go ahead and bring it to me.
Yep. It's second period coming up. Two teams, there's some difference between the two teams. What does I know there's not a lot of flow to this game. Is that to North Shore's advantage?
You know, I think so. You saw the pace, 13 seconds. That was a nice D-to-D or cross-ice pass by Carson Pavlovich, and they're off to the races. Sometimes a start like that can almost, you know, make you think that your bet is made right away, and North Shore pushed back nicely. You know, I think a huge piece of this game for Proctor is going to be making sure that they maintain good habits, play the right way, you know, push and pace, don't get on the skis, forecheck the right way, and really pressure their defense. And, you know, we put some good pucks deep But in the neutral zone, I think we could clean it up just a little bit.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, appreciate it.
All right, former Royals goaltender Terry Dunbar. We didn't talk about what he's doing today, but maybe in a future broadcast, another 50 years.
Yeah, that sounds good. I'll be here.
All right, Terry, thank you. We'll come back. We'll have second period hockey. The Rails lead 2-0 after one. It's Section 7 Single-A playoff hockey right here on Rails TV.
Unbaked pizza, subs, tacos, wraps, salads, tater tots, nachos, burritos, and more. Proctor's local family business for over 35 years. Proctor Pizza offers brand new monthly specials, such as the Taco Pizza, Bacon Cheeseburger Pizza, Hawaiian Pizza, and more. Proctor Pizza.
Maintenance and repair in the Northland. With brands such as Aluma, Look, Pace, and more, we have a trailer for every need. Don't forget, we also sell and install snowplows for all vehicle types. Searching for a Mahindra tractor? We have you covered with over 8 different models in stock and ready to tackle projects of all sizes. Wittes Trailer Sales in Esco, where customers become friends.
Who will our next generation be? What will they achieve? At Proctor Public Schools, we create an environment to educate, engage, and inspire our students to seek adventure, gain knowledge, and make a difference. Proctor Public Schools, we see greatness in our students and great things for their future. We educate, engage, and inspire.
Who will our next generation be? What will they achieve? At Proctor Public Schools, we see great things in the future as we create an environment to educate, engage, and
back at the St. Luke's Hockey and Event Center, Steve Jezerski with you on Rails TV as the Rails and North Shore Storm playing in the Section 7 Single-A playoffs. A 2-0 lead for the Rails at the end of one period. A couple of Wyatt Meinhein goals, 13 seconds in, and at the 9:30 mark of the power play, assisting on the first goal, Nolan Oakes did, and Carson Pavlovich, along with Pavlovich again, and A.J. Riles on the power play goal. And again, these two teams, this is the second meeting, one during the regular season. The goaltender Riles also assisted in that game. The Rails will go from left to right in the second period. I want to thank Terry Dunbar for stopping by. He's going to try and line somebody up for us during the second intermission. Rails Hockey on Rails TV brought to you by Proctor Pizza and Sub Shop, Main Street Proctor. Love the tacos. Leadership tonight working with us, two great guys, Spencer Maida. He is the director and producer. And also Tanner Hargraves. He's on the camera tonight, scoreboard, tech reporter. We've got the best with us working here tonight as the Rails lead 2-0 at the end of one. Stadler on the faceoff at center, and he'll face it off along with, who was that? No, it was Davidson, 19. Long puck into the zone, back into behind the net, played at the net, Minder Bentler's right, from the inboard to the front, they score! Oh my goodness! Reckon Ross says, to Wyatt Meinhein, I can do it faster than you can. 12 seconds in, but if truth be known, Meinhein's goal was 12 seconds in as well. They just let the clock run an extra second. And so, officially, yes. Brecken Ross was quicker.
Brecken Ross. He got an assist on the goal for number 19, Dylan Davidson, and number 20, Wyatt Meinhein.
Davidson and Meinhein assisting on that goal. And so Meinhein's got points in all three goals tonight, a three-point night thus far. Rails come out and start fast, build on the lead. We'll get a face-off at Brecklin's right, or Bentler's right, rather. Zach Bentler. They've got Althaus out there facing off. And the Rails win the draw doing so. Was Bryant, quick shot from the top from Tanner Ross, and his shot right on, and Bentler had it right between his, the side of his body and his right arm, his stick side. Kept it long enough to draw a whistle. Bryant and Althaus again on the faceoff. On the faceoff, they tie up. Finally, the Rails. Tanner Ross to the right side for Cooper Johnson. Johnson a shot. Blocker save. Rebound right up the gut. Swat at it. And now they'll take it to carry it out to center ice and sent into the zone by Weirman. Andrew Weirman. Rails have possession in their own end. Touch pass across to Tanner Ross up the right side into the zone. Here comes Giswold giving to the circle. Closing short side shot right on. The save made. The rebound to the far circle. One of the Storm falls. Makes a pass to the near wing. It comes out to center. Swatting at it, Cooper Johnson. It goes back into behind the Storm goal. Now in behind the net, around to the near corner, being played by the Rails. Down low with the Giswold on the inboard to Ross. Ross in behind the net. Here's Ross. He'll feed it back using the boards. And that is escapes the point man all the way out to center, Nolan Oakstead. Pavlovich in the pass to the blue line into the zone, right down the slot. Here's the shot taken by Bryant, and it came back at him in behind along the end board. Tanner Ross will play it. Ross spots a pass back to the right point to Pavlovich. Here's Pavlovich now losing it along the near wall, lifted out to center ice, and Oakstead will let it come to him. Gives it ahead on the left. Bryant's short pass didn't get a whole lot on it. Tanner Ross will finish it and put it deep into the zone, and the Rails are changing. They've got the offensive end right in front of their own bench here in the second period. Puck over in the far corner, far edge of the circle, played back into behind the net. Now the Rails will get that puck from the near corner. Being played by Carter, Ethan Carter will take it and reverse it back to the corner. Endboard pass into the slot, a shot taken, stick save made, and it's played to the far side. Boising had taken that shot, it comes out to center. Now the Rails and Anila, Cooper Anila, his pass at center. Intercepted, give it a back, turning, shooting it inside the zone is Carter. It'll go in behind. Rails with possession, being played by Boysen. Boysen has it taken off his stick. On the wing boards, play to the far side. Kicked off the skates of Stadler into the corner. Joining in the corner for the Rails is Towers. Now Towers checking, Boysen is checking as well. Two on one, Stadler, two on two. Work free into the circle, Rails have it. Boysen puts it to the front. It goes through Carter, near circle shot taken. A blocker save, rebound to the far circle. And they'll try to move that puck out of the zone. It's hoisted out by Anderson ahead to the blue line and back deep into the rail zone. Davidson. Long pass up the near wing. That was Gavin Davidson ahead of the right. Knocked down along the near wall was Densler. It'll come back out to center. Dylan Densler for the Rails. Over to the far wing boards. Into the rail zone on the right wing. Through the circle. Trying to make the pass. It goes around and behind. Center to the front. A shot by Althaus. On a pass by Norman. Now on the near wing boards out to center. And they'll take and shoot it right back in. Aiden Althaus. It's played over on the far wing, just inside the line. Over into the far corner, the Rails will go for that puck. We'll get a whistle. 13-27, second period of hockey, 3-0 Rails. They have outshot the visitors by a 22-5 margin. A.J. Riles not real busy here tonight. Zach Bentler has seen 22 shots and made 19 saves. Althaus along with Peterson, and that's Cade Peterson. And also Cade Norman. Face off of the Rails, get possession. Oakstead around to the left of the pass. Nice touch pass. Give it a back. Carried up the left wing into the zone. Bryant trying to squeeze by the defender. Bryant does. Bottom of the circle. Hoist one. That one over the top of the crossbar. Back out the glass. And that one on the side of the net. We'll get a whistle. They'll call that puck frozen. And we'll get a faceoff. Good talking with Terry Dunbar. I have gotten to know him through a good friend, and he works for and with Tim Madsen, the former St. Scholastica and also Minnesota junior hockey coach with the Wilderness. Terry's a great guy. Right side, Pavlovich with a shot right on, and the save made by Bentler. He'll keep it. Carson just looks like a hockey player. Danner Ross facing off with Stadler. And they're going to chase Stadler and bring Weirman in. On the face out the rails when the draw save is made on the shot taken by Bryant in the slot towards the net, and it'll be gobbled up at the right and his right by netminder Bentler. One penalty that was on Stadler in the first period. Einheit had scored on that power play. Royals power play 15% on the season. Penalty kill for the Storm at 87, so the Royals power play one out. A point drive, and it's fired wide. On the shot taken by Tanner Ross, around and in behind to the far side. Tikkanen sends it up the right wing. That'll go the distance. Will we get icing? No, we won't. Out to play it as Ryle sends it around to the near side. Pavlovich giving. It's kept in on the left side by Stadler. Stadler trying to drag it into the slot area. Good job of defending by the Rails and Giswold. And here's the pass up the far wing. Back into the Storm zone. Played off the far boards by Bryant. Tried to send it across to the front. Nobody was there. They break it up on the intercept. And out to center they come with the Peterson. Now Peterson will send one in, and there's two Petersons, Cade and Cam, and it's Cade, or rather Cam, who sends it in deep. Saints in on the right, rather the Rails in on the right. I knew I was going to do that. I know who the home team is, that's for sure. Hot shot for the far side. Glove by Bentler, he'll keep it. And again, my regular job with the Saints Scholastica Saints. They've got playoff hockey on Saturday at Bethel. We'll have the section finals, A and AA, on WDIO. Craig Caracas and myself, I think, for the 19th consecutive year. Now the Storm trying to advance. Rails will keep the puck in the zone. The ice has been tilted here in this period. There's a shot, and that's deflected wide by Davidson's stick. They'll play it around the far wing boards. Trying to jam it up the wall. That's plugged up by the Rails and Davidson. Wasn't Davidson. It's 21. And yes, it was Gavin Davidson. Half wall. And that one's lifted into the far corner, up the far wing. And they look to break it out, and they do. Anderson sending it across, trying to close. He wanted to give it back. That was Hoff. Hoff had received the pass, wanted to give it back. Puck will come to the front on a deflection. And Riles will take it to cover it and keep it. Section 7A hockey, Rails hockey, tonight on Rails TV, brought to you by Reed, Rails Endowment for Academics, Arts, and Athletic Development, as well as Irving Community Club, Pulling for Kids, Tamrac Building Supplies, Highway 53 in Hermantown, and Heritage Window and Door, Superior, Wisconsin. Rails from the faceoff will fire around to the far side. Towers. Now they'll bring it out to center. Carter into the zone. A shot and a glove save. May have been high. Might have been high. And Bentler will keep it. And we'll get another faceoff in the North Shore end. And Jake Stadler on the draw with the Rails and Ethan Carter. Rails poison a shot and that save that's just above the pads going down on his knees. Bentler and gloving and keeping. Stadler again along with Davidson. And the faceoff won and controlled by North Shore. Now pass out to center, trying to gather that in was Norman. They'll take and send it in deep, handled by Riles, back into behind the goal. Riles will send it around to the far side, Towers pass to his right. Davidson giving to Boysen on the right. Here's Boysen through the circle, down low angle shot. That'll be saved and deflected to the far side. And then driving that net off its moorings was Boysen. And following a shot,
actually had no choice. 10-18 here in the second. Royals leading 3-0. A couple of Meinheim goals. 1:13 seconds in, and then 12 seconds into this period, it was Brecken Ross. Officially 1 second earlier than that scored by Meinheim into the opening up of the game. Now from that faceoff near side, it goes all the way to the other side of the ice, taken away. Tanner Ross circling behind the net, comes around the near side. Ross, he'll give it back to his right as he circles to his left. It goes down the wall into the corner. Picked up by Althaus of North Shore, passing to his right. They look to bring it out. And out come to the far side. They'll play it ahead to the blue line. Broken up there. Rails get it back. They have not given North Shore the puck very often here tonight. It's over on the far wing. Bryant, Austin Bryant's pass. That'll go right through Giswold and up to neutral North Shore. On the near wing with Meeks. Punctuated as kept in by Weirman. And then the Rails get it back. And the Rails will play with Cooper Johnson. Johnson to the boards along the near side. Left it along the wall. Sent back the other way by Mason Parmeter. I think that's our 18, or is it their 18 I'm looking at? Played from in behind and ahead and out to center. Now the pass chopped down by Stadler, but following up on it and carrying in was Tanner Ross, but his two teammates had already crossed the blue line on that puck that was chopped down. Davidson's out there along with his line mates, Brecken Ross and Meinheim. They've got the 3 goals in this game. Puck to the front, trying to backhand, not able to get that shot off was Meinheim, and that net knocked loose in the process. He's not afraid to go to the net. Honestly, I think Kevin Morrison thought that net had come loose, and maybe it was knocked up and it came back down. Now they're going to go over and wiggle it. Oh, yes, it did. It did come off. He wanted something to take it, to brush some snow out of that area to put it back in place before putting it back in place. Got the short peg, so you, when you run into it, it'll give. And they'll spray a little water around it. It's supposed to freeze right away. Shots at 30-7 in this one. The Rails leading 3-0 in the second period. 9:01 remaining. Meinheim is going to take the faceoff. And he'll do so with Stadler in the North Shore end. Meinheim wins that faceoff, but North Shore has the puck momentarily. Out to neutral it comes. Getting it off, he'll put it in deep, right to the net. Save is made by A.J. Riles. Pavlovich back in behind. Now here's Pav, he'll angle a pass. That's tipped out to neutral by Davidson. They'll go after it. On the back wall, North Shore getting there first. Backhand to pass, fielded nicely by Stadler out to neutral. In on the left, here's Stadler. He'll take a screenshot right on. Glove save made by Riles. Some good movement there by North Shore coming out of their own end. Both teams changing lines. I had somebody go get lines. I got here late tonight. Again, I had late notice on this, blaming no one. I've done it before, so I wasn't worried about it. But on the other hand, took some time as I had it today to kind of prepare as best I could, and was looking for line combinations from North Shore, and Coach Lundgren told who I had asked if he'd stop by. And he said, got 7 players, we'll rotate up front, 3 defensemen, and he said anything I put down paper isn't going to do any good, and I understand what he's saying. Now the faceoff comes back along the near boards. There's a saucering shot to the net, and it's gloved on the shot taken by Tikkanen from the left point. And Riles will save. That's his 10th.
Shutout effort thus far. Three on the season for AJ, five for the Rails this season. Rails have never lost more than two games in a row. They had one to end the season, 4-1, as they lost to Mrs. North Shore. And that was Northern Lakes, up there in that beautiful lake area of Crosby, Ironton, and such. Out to center. Althaus giving ahead at center. Broken up. Boyson on the intercept. Gives it right back. Just outside of neutral. Trying to touch a pass ahead. Getting checked is Norman. On the check by Boyson. Put back into behind the North Shore net. And on a Tikkanen. He'll pass it ahead on the right. Hunter Tikkanen. Pass over to the near wing. We're playing in the North Shore end in a 3-0 game into period number two. 2-on-2 in the corner as they battle there. And the Rails will come up with a puck. Loose puck to the top of the circle. Banked out the boards. Out to center. Backing up with it. Sending it right back in to Cooper Johnson. That's played from the back wall. Taken in over on the far wing. Outlet pass. Intercepted. Brought in. The Rails are offside. Now the puck back out to neutral. And Cooper Johnson will put it right back in. Their defenseman will play it ahead. Sent ahead by Carpenter. Jared Carpenter kept in. Pass to the near circle. Intended for Tanner Ross. That came off a stick. Out to neutral ice. Sent ahead of the right with the Rails. And Pavlovich will give it to the near side. Back out to neutral. And Pavlovich will take and shoot it right back in. Back into behind the net. Racing back into behind the goal was Giswold. And we get a whistle as the net is knocked loose again. This time to the far side. Shots at 30-10, the score in favor of the Rails at 3-0. Hockey on Rails Television, brought to you by the Tamrac Building Supplies, Highway 53 in Hermantown, Heritage Window and Door, Superior, Wisconsin, and Wittes Trailer Sales in Esco. Giswold left it behind the net, center to the front, and that one deflected wide by the glove of the netminder, Bentler, and out to center. I want to say that was Ross who got the shot off. No, it was 14. Ross got the shot off. I think it was Austin Bryant back into behind the net or vice versa. One made the pass, the other one got the shot off, and the Rails will get a penalty. And it's going to be Tanner Ross. I just saw the end of the signification, but let's let Mark Fleischer tell us. Time of the penalty is 10:15.
Called on the Rails, number 7, Tanner Ross. That penalty charging.
Ross for charging. Two minute minor. They'll play at half boards. Power play hockey for North Shore. Their power play at about 14%. The Rails penalty kill at about 80% if you round up a few points. Now picked up top of the slot. Played into the near circle. Back to the left point to Stadler. A shot tipped to the net actually by the Rail defender. And Oakstead, it was from his stick. It goes to the end board being played at goaltender Ryle's left. Now off the wall, played by Carpenter. Carpenter into the circle, high slot, top of the near circle shot taken, altered by a stick. Stadler had taken the shot, altered by the stick of Dylan Davidson. It's cleared all the way down. And goaltender, Bentler, played it to the far side, picked up by Stadler, passing to Althaus on the near side. He'll go cross rink on the pass, and then tipped ahead, trying to get to it, is Meeks. And the Rails will send it the other way out to neutral ice. Pass to Stadler. Power play hockey for the Storm. Long one in. Back into behind the net. Ryle stopping it behind there for Oakstead. Here's Oakstead checked in the corner. And that one will be played around over to the far wing. And then a long saucering pass down the ice. That one now on the ice and played by Bentler. A hit for Stadler. Here's Stadler on the rush in the near wing into the zone. Stadler through the circle. Backhand shot in Ryle's little glove. His glove had it went to the puck. And he will catch it and keep it. We'll get a face off at AJ's right. 37 seconds remaining on the power play for North Shore. Face off with the Cooper Johnson. He'll reverse it for Analog. That'll continue around. Comes out to neutralize. Stadler tipping it for Anderson. Cale Anderson losing it to the rails, and Anilon. Anila will set it up the near wing. That will escape. Stadler, he's played the whole power play. Stadler comes off the back wall. Now Stadler gives it, gets it back from Althaus. Gives it to Althaus in on the left, dropping. Shot to the net, save made on the shot by Cade Norman. To the front, a little bit of a scramble, picked up and unable to clear. Cooper Johnson near wing, back along the boards for Stadler. Fired along the wall for Cole Anderson, back to the behind the net, over to the far corner, and the rails have killed the penalty. Back to 5-on-5 hockey. Althaus, long shot, getting a stick and blocker on it. A.J. Riles into the corner, along the boards at the circle. Now ahead in the near wing, out to center with a pass to the left, chasing it to the far boards. Bryant over skate, stops. He will take and play it through some feet, sends it across to the near side from the boards. Tanner Ross back to the right point to Pavlovich. It's over on the far wing. Along the far wing boards with a shot that's knocked down before it gets to the net. Oaksted with that shot, and it's cleared the other way, and that'll go into the rail zone. We'll get icing called on the North Shore Storm. Hockey Tonight on Rails TV, brought to you by Stream Dudes, Great Lakes Office Solutions, and Rob and Barb Schaller Charitable Foundation. Ethan Carter on the faceoff with Cade Peterson. North Shore and Cook are onto the near side of the pass. Trying to move it up the wall, and then it's through the legs, pass across, carried into the zone, and we get an offside called on the shot attempt by Braylon Hoff. Boy, we've had more miscues on faceoffs tonight than I've seen in a long time. The college game I follow at Division III, it's kind of prevalent there, and this year I just don't remember much of it whatsoever. Probably have had at least a half dozen, maybe closer to 10, where we've had do-overs on faceoffs or a whistle before the puck is dropped. Now the rails coming out of their own zone on the left. Towers into the zone, puts it to the net right down. That rebound was right up the gut. Boyson unable to get there in as timely of a fashion as he wanted. North Shore in its own zone, sent across, played from the wall by Peterson. Taken away, Boyson has it. Here's Boyson stick handling to the far boards. Gives it back to the left point. Skated along the far side with a shot to the net right on. Good hard shot by Gavin Davidson. He's got a little something in those wrists. .313 in the second period, 3-0 Rails. Dylan Davidson, he'll take the faceoff with Cole Anderson. And North Shore will win that faceoff, trying to come ahead with it. Unable to do so was Stadler. He'll get the puck now. Sends it to the near boards. Norman can't play it. Rails take it away, bring it in on the right with Meinahine. They get it back and set a rink wide in on the right. Anderson through the circle, closing shot, save made. Read it point blank as he went right in on AJ. Got the glove on it. Loose to the far circle. Now turning, retreating, going back into behind his net. Anila. Here's Cooper Anila on the pass on the left. Meinahine sending it a rink wide into the zone. Bracken Ross, and he forgot the puck along the near wall. Out to center. Gavin Davidson sends it across. Now being played by Pavlovich. He'll give it ahead on the left wing. Poke checked away from a pair of guys battling for that puck. Played through the far circle by Ross. Brecken Ross. It's played back into behind, around to the near side, to the front. Intended for Ross. Pass behind him. And North Shore will bring it out along with Norman. Cade Norman throws it in deep on the left side. Pavlovich will go back in to play it. Here's Carson. He'll carry it back into behind his net. Peeks to the right, steps to the right. Now fires a pass back to his left. They'll send it up the left wing and then sent into the zone by Meinahine. From back to the behind, up the far boards, to the high slot, center blue line, shot taken, analog, loved wide, but kept by netminder Bentler. Zach Bentler, he's got 31 saves on 34 shots, and we've got a period plus a minute 44 here in the second period yet to play. Caught up in skates, high slot, in the slot. Here's Bryant passing to the front, jamming at it was Ross. Tanner Ross down low. Bryant chasing, or rather Ross chasing it along the near boards. It's loose, picked up, banked out the boards, but kept into the rails. And Bryant, taken from a stick and forced out to neutral ice by Weirman. He'll take and send it into the zone to right to the net. And Riles will take and sweep it to his defenseman, Anila, plays it inboard around to the near side. Cooper Johnson's pass out to center for Giswold. In on the right, giving and having it checked away from behind. Good job by the stick of Peterson. Now back to the right point, center blue line, into the slot, turning, firing. That one's wide of the mark of the shot by Bryant on the near side. We've got less than a minute now remaining in the period. 3-0 with the Rails leading. Inboard around to the near side. Got a penalty coming up. We've got a penalty coming up with 47.8 seconds left. Interference is going to be the call on North Shores, Cam Peterson. Cam Peterson for interference. Time of the penalty, 16-13. Second power play for the Rails. They are one of one on a Meinheim snipe. Meinheim on the faceoff. Near corner. Carter sends it back to the right point. Anila shot right on. Bad save, rebound to the far boards. Played back to the left point. Cooper Johnson. Cooper Anila to Johnson. They play catch. Here's Anila passing atop the near circle for Oakstead. High slot shot. That one's deflected to the near side. Now being played back to the blue line. Long distance shot. That one tipped wide. Good action in front from the stick of Ethan Carter. And we've got one of the North Shore players knocked down to back into behind. We may have another penalty here on the Rails now. Kevin Morrison skating over to the box again, and it will be on the Rails, and it will be on Wyatt Meinheim. Meinheim is going to go. Two-minute minor for interference. Closer to 16:45 with 0.9 left on that 16.9, nearly 17 seconds. Shot to the front and through traffic. Riles is able to spot it and save it, and he'll keep it. He was being fronted pretty well. Face off at AJ's right. They win the draw, but the Saints control the puck. Outlet pass is behind Meinheim. That'll go deep out. I said Meinheim with a penalty. It's 19. My mistake. That's Dylan Davidson. And there's a pass that's put to the front and a shot sent wide. Davidson with a penalty, not Meinheim. My mistake. Davidson. 19. I knew it was 19, but that's Davidson. And so the two teams playing four-on-four hockey. It'll be a minute 12 of penalty time into the second period on the Storm and Peterson. And then Davidson's penalty has 1:42 to go into period number three. So we'll start 4-on-4. This one 3-0 Rails at the end of two periods of play. They scored twice in the first on a pair of goals from Meinheim, including a power play goal, one in the second, and that from Brecken Ross. And penalties in the period, three here in the second period, two carrying over, one for each team into the third period. We'll come back with more during the second intermission. You're watching Rails Hockey on Rails TV.
For years, Troy Service Center has been the go-to auto repair shop in the Proctor community. Quality and efficient repairs make it more convenient to have your vehicle serviced. Troy's has always been for the community. That's why they have been favored by Proctorians alike. But don't just take our word for it. Check out the many reviews on their service. Troy's Service Center can ensure that your vehicle keeps your life driving forward for years to come. Troy Service Center has been servicing and repairing vehicles for three generations. To contact Troy Service Center, call 218-642-3322 or visit troyservice.com.
Can't hear the TV? Need to protect your hearing? Audiology Concepts connects patients to their lives again by offering ear cleanings, providing earplugs for protection in loud environments, and helping people get hearing aids. Audiology Concepts also offers hearing evaluations, verification of hearing aids, and hearing aid repairs. There are 7 different locations across Minnesota and Wisconsin. Audiology Concepts, you'll love what you hear.
We're back at the St. Luke's Hockey and Event Center. Steve Chizerski with you on Tuesday night. Nate Regas is joining me. And Nate, did I see your number on the assistant coach list?
Yes. Okay. So I do. I obviously, like Terry was telling you, I work here in Proctor. I work for the athletic director, facility director here. We work out of the rink, so I assist him with all game day operations and stuff. Coach soccer along with Anthony Wood. And then, I am on staff, mostly with the JV guys, but I'm on staff here with the Rails.
I just want to go on record that I didn't go out and just grab somebody. Come and join me. I found out your name. And then I was given another title, and I thought, I think I remember your name from something.
Yep.
Hey, you're watching your team play here after two periods, up 3-0, and could be worse for North Shore, 37-17, the shots.
Right.
Geez, that 17, that jumped up from 10-17 in a hurry.
Yeah.
What have you seen through two periods here? Have you seen what we saw 12 days ago, similar?
Yeah, I think so. Obviously, you get a goal, 17 seconds into the first period, and then 13 seconds into the second, something like that?
It was actually 13 into the first, but it was 12 seconds. They let the clock run.
Gotcha.
My philosophy was that Brecken Ross said, I can do it faster than you.
Right.
He got on the board 12 seconds
even though
that first one was also 12. And so, yeah, there's a bet on there. You settle that. I officially saw it.
Yeah, okay. I'll let him know. But, no, obviously, it starts like that, the start of the period, set the tone. I would like to see our boys, you know, stay on the gas a little bit more. I feel like they kind of came off it both in the first and the second period. I think a lot of the play in the second period was in their zone. We did a much better job in the second period, I think, utilizing the middle of the ice. Another assistant coach, Andy, and I noticed that and talked with, you know, the other coaching staff and whatnot and made that a focal point in between intermissions. So we utilized the middle a lot, even with our breakouts and neutral zone and stuff. So I think that helped keep the puck in the offensive zone, the one we want to play in.
It's been a banner season. I know Terry said you've got to go back to his senior year for as many wins as you guys had this year, and you've enjoyed it along the way. Has there been one win, one game, or a moment where you said, yeah, we've got a good thing going here?
I would probably, even though we didn't play the best against them to end the regular season, but the Northern Lakes game.
Your championship game
at
here.
At the end of December when we were in the
Bill
the
McGann.
Championship game. Yeah,
yeah.
Championship game of our home tournament. I guess I can give you that. you know, because that's third year we put that tournament on, I believe, and we haven't brought the tournament home. So one of the boys' goals was they said, bring Billy home. So that was, I think, you know, that tournament as a whole, we came together as a team, played really good hockey, and then to get it done, get the trophy, we got a flag hanging in the locker room right now. So I think that was a big push for our season, and then we just kind of kept it going after that, rattled on. I want to say we were on a 6 or 7 game win streak around somewhere in there. So I think that was... it's a big push in our season.
How are you guys relative to goals? Do you have like little goals along the way, or is it like a couple of big ones?
So we left it up to, we told our captains to kind of pull the guys aside inside the locker room, and they made a goal pyramid. And at the top, obviously, you put the X, and a couple of the smaller ones were bring Billy home, you know, win a playoff game, get to Amsoil, you know, make the semifinals. So we're on track to kind of stay on with those goals. You know, we got Billy home. On track to get the playoff game, you know, on track to get to the semifinal. So we're going the right direction.
I'll tell you a Bill McGann story. I was in high school here when Coach McGann was coaching back in 1972, my senior year, of course, and never had him for Phi Ed.
And there were horror stories about how he threw kids into lockers and threw lockers and you know, and lifted them up off the floor and so on and so forth. And so I had Mr. Chapman, who was a wonderful gentleman, and Fayed was very structured. Yep. Well, anyway, my senior year, how in the world I had credits to play with, but I did. And so I took Fayed when I didn't have to. I got Mr. McGann. I'm thinking, oh, my God. And I was still too you know, young, dumb, and naive to realize if you behave, you're probably not going to get tossed through the locker.
Yep.
And so anyway, yes, he did those things, but it was only the kids who deserved it.
Yeah, I've heard a couple stories from, you know, some of the coaches and playing back then with him and stuff like that. But I don't think Coach Laspy and Coach Danielson are doing that in Fayed class anymore.
No. Kids don't do things to deserve that either. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. When Terry brought you over, he introduced you as being involved with another program. And tell me what that is.
Yep. So that's the Minnesota CCM High Performance. Specifically, me, Terry, and a couple other guys, we work with the U15 age group. So I believe this year we are dealing with 09 birth years. And basically what that is, we try and take the best kids from our youth district, District 11, and we form a team and we go down and play at down in Plymouth, Minnesota at a showcase festival. And there's the U15s are there. They have a U16, I think final 54, which is the best 54 kids at that age in Minnesota. Plus they have there's another U18 kind of senior junior tournament going on where they bring in high performance teams from Michigan, North Dakota, Wisconsin. So it's a really cool festival, and it's just 3 days of hockey, really high level hockey. And you know, just walking around there, it was like I told Terry, I've been there for 3 years, and you walk around these rinks, because in Plymouth they have three sheets of ice, so there's something going all the time, and you see NHL jackets, college jackets, you know, anything coaches scouting wise, from Chicago to the Bulldogs to D3 schools, it's pretty impressive just to feel like, see some of the faces that you're there with, some of the coaches you see on TV at the D1 level and the NHL level that are there watching these kids play at such a young age.
What's the ultimate objective? Is it exposure? Is it for kids to be able to see and experience playing this game at such a high level?
Kind of both. From our standpoint with the 15s, it's both. So as I mentioned, the 16s have their final 54 there. As the 15 level, we go there and basically play a round-robin pool play against teams from other districts. So I think there's about 16 teams down there. So each pool is four teams, so you get three games, one on each day. And at the 15 level, our goal is to try, and it's essentially a tryout, right? From our team, we pick our teams. They're running a tryout here. We pick our teams, go down there. It's another tryout. So they pick the best teams out of these 16 teams, or the best kids from these 16 teams that are down there, and then they'll take 54 of them to a final 54 camp, which they do in St. Cloud at the university. They put the kids up, and I think that's a week-long event. They put the kids up in the dorms on campus, D1 coaches, D1 players. They basically run a camp, and then from there, they pick a team of, I want to say it's 20. They'll head to a national CCM camp in, I believe it's somewhere in New York, Buffalo area, out east, and then they'll run a tournament against teams from all over the country. So Nate, it's, like you said, exposure is really the big opportunity there.
Nate Regas joining us, an assistant coach with the Rails and involved with hockey overall. Rails leading 3-0 after two periods here in the Section 7A playoff game. 15 years old. Obviously, you have people, you have players who excel at that age, but overall, taking a more broad look at it, where does 15 years old fit in as far as development and players being who they are, that sort of thing?
Right, so it's that Bantam level here in Minnesota, and that's, now that they changed the rules from back when I played, that's that first or second year that they're actually able to body check and, you know, play a little bit more physical. So it's interesting to see how that translates as kids are, you know, getting bigger, they're adding a little bit more muscle. So it's an interesting stage in a kid's life. And then they get to this opportunity to obviously play at this high level. And I mean, you see it on display right now. You know, I've had my first year, I believe that was my first year with AJ and our senior defenseman Carson Pavlich and the junior defenseman Cooper Anila were on those teams, just some of the Proctor kids that went through the program. And then there's we had Max Plant, AJ Francisco last year. He's at Hermantown now this year. So there's a lot of skill that comes through this program, and it's fun to watch them, you know, grow. You know, as seeing with the Proctor kids, obviously I'm a little closer with them, so seeing them go from the Bantam level into that 15, get the exposure that, you know, someone like AJ has, and then see them come all the way through and how, you know, good they're playing here at the senior high school level too.
Boy, Pavlich, he's a hockey player, isn't he? I mean, he just has the look. I mean, you just watch him up and down the ice, and right away you wouldn't have to know the game. You could just say, oh, he's a hockey player.
Right. Yeah. It's him and AJ both with, you know, they started the year, I believe, well, AJ was hurt, but Pav was in New Mexico playing NA3. Both of them are kind of doing the online thing, transitioning between high school and juniors. And I, like I said, I work here at the rink, and every day these guys, they're bugging me. You got open ice. Can I come skate? You know, can I do this? Can I do that? So it's really cool to see the work ethic that some of these athletes have put into it and still put into it, and see what position and opportunities that they've gotten.
I see the skill level of these other kids like the Meinheims and, yep, and Bryant and the Rosses. Yep. And who's unsung? You got guys with numbers, but is there an unsung guy here?
That's a tough one. Put me on the spot like that. Unsung.
I like what I've seen from Boysen.
Yeah. I mean, that quote-unquote third line that we have is actually, that line as a whole has done basically everything that we've kind of asked them to, especially in this game, you know.
And Carter impresses me, too.
Yeah, all three of them are just, they've played the game correct. They're playing simple. They're not overcomplicating. If they don't have an odd man rush, they're putting pucks in deep. They're going to get it. They go to the net hard and just playing simple hockey. It's kind of an identity that we like to, you know, showcase here in Proctor. You know, not the super flashy stuff, but put your work boots on and go to work type of mentality. So it's fun to watch.
You mentioned work here at the rink. My second time in here, actually, I came in here, really? And I think you had a state tournament here last year where I came and spoke at a banquet, and I was just totally impressed. Didn't see any games, but now to see a game here, what a facility.
Yeah, so I, being a Denfeld grad myself in 16, when I played Proctor, we were always the fairgrounds, you know, so I coming here, working here, coaching here, I kind of look around and it's like, God, did they need this? Oh my God, it's incredible. And then, you know, you have obviously the rinks here, so the hockey aspect is here, but the amount of use that we get in our room upstairs above the concession stand, we call it the community room, you know, grad parties, bridal showers, you know, class reunions, you name it, and the amount of walkers that we get to, retired people that just come and walk the track early in the morning, it's actually really nice just to see how the community as a whole uses this building, not just specifically the hockey team.
Fantastic. Nate, thank you so much.
Yeah, I appreciate you having me.
All right, Nate Regas joining us during the second intermission. Third period hockey about to begin with the Rails leading by a 3-0 score at the end of two. Steve Chizurski with you from the St. Luke's Hockey and Event Center. I've got my bodyguards, who are also the producer and camera scoreboard, deck reporter, operators up here. And, of course, that being Spencer Maida and Tanner Hargraves. They've taken care of me here. Goals in the game. First two from Meinheim in the first, from Nolan Oakstead and Carson Pavlich. And Pavlich again with Riles assisting on Meinheim's second goal. And then Davidson and Meinheim assisting on the Brecken Ross goal in the second period. Shots at 37-17 in favor of the Rails. Third period hockey coming up from the St. Luke's Hockey and Event Center. Rails will go from right to left here in the third period. North Shore Storm. Combination from two great areas, two harbors and Silver Bay. William Kelly High School in the bay. It's just up there last week, in fact. Would love to have seen Roger Coster. I know he's retired. I'm guessing I don't know if he's up in Baudette. Well, here we go. Third period hockey. Great to have you with us. Rails will control. Bryant giving to Tanner Ross. Skated off of the far wing boards. Out to neutral. Stadler coming back. They're only down 3-0, as one-sided as it has been for most of this game. It's only a 3-0 deficit. They get one. North Shore does, and it becomes a two-goal game. Of course, one at a time, and they can't give one up. Well, we are already well past the 12 and 13 second mark. The Rails had scored 13 seconds into the first period and 12 into the second, so there will be nothing to beat those numbers, and we're going to get icing. Two teams did start 4-on-4. I guess I neglected to mention that. 29 seconds remaining on the penalty to North Shore's Cam Peterson, and a 59 seconds on the penalty to Dylan Davidson. Stadler on the faceoff along with the Meinheim. Faceoff goes to the back wall, being played by Cooper Johnson. Johnson giving near side. Now Meinheim's pass, and that was broken up by the stick of Stadler. Out to center it comes. They'll come back to it, trying to give it ahead was Carpenter. Rails will play it over on the far wing. That'll come back into the Shore, North Shore zone, in behind the net. Checking back into behind the goal was Meinheim. And North Shore now will break it out. Rink wide pass out to neutral ice to his right. Sidestepping Carpenter. Now being forecheck. Meinheim trying to steal the puck away. Meinheim going after him into the corner. Meinheim checking on as they go into the corner. And the puck ahead to the blue line. Skid it ahead up the right wing. Into the zone. Here's Cole Anderson. Anderson fires a drive right on. And that glove save made. Dropped. And we get a whistle. And we get a faceoff. Should the Rails continue as they are, they will win and play on Saturday night at Hermantown in all likelihood. They drop it. We'll do it again. 1, 2, 3, 4. They had a fifth player over at the bench, and that was Tucker Cook. And so they dropped it and said, "Oh, Tucker's not here," and blew the whistle and said, "Let's do it again." Chase the center. That was Althaus. Stadler took that draw. They control. Peterson, Cam Peterson, angle shot, drives it. That one might have hit the side of the net. And it's cleared all the way down right on net. And now back at a full strength is Proctor. Both teams have their fifth player on the ice. Peterson's pass out to center, ahead on the left for Anderson. Rails end up with a puck from their own blue line, tipped ahead of the near wing on the pass. It's played at neutral ice, given across, broken up by Boysen. Comes off a boot, picked up by Anderson of North Shore, has it taken away by Boysen, in turn gives it. Losing it is Carter, Ethan Carter, and the puck comes into the rail end. Oakstead, in behind, sends it on the near wing on the pass for Towers, Kellen Towers. Now back into behind for Pavlovich. Pavlovich and giving it to Carter, who lost it out to neutral, back into the Proctor zone, skated back in and behind the goal. There's a pass up the near side, banked ahead by Towers, out to neutral ice, and picked up, and Tikkanen sends a long one in. That one stopped by Riles, played, carried back into behind, routing to his left. He's got the wheels going. Here we go. Tanner Ross out to center. Now Ross widening out to his right. He'll cut it back towards the middle. Toe drag shot right on. Save made by goaltender Brettler. He'll keep it. Tanner Ross had every intention of doing that. He had the puck back in his own end on the near wing and weaved his way and found his way into the zone and then toe-dragged at the high slot, got himself open and fired a wicked shot with the Bettler saving. That was nice. We'll do that face-off again. Go back, Jack, do it again. It's off, caught up in skates, taken by the Rails. Austin Bryant. Here's Bryant. Some nifty stick handling. He got double and triple team. Giswold sends it to the boards. Back to the right point. Analyst passed down low at the bottom of the far circle, but taken back into behind the net by Tikkanen. And his pass on the right side for Stadler. Stadler taken down along the near boards, and they let that go with the stick of Bryant. Now Bryant at center, had it stripped into the zone. Stadler widens out, gives it, directed to the net right on, and Riles the save. Bryant getting a little feisty.
Cole Anderson took the feed from Stadler. The moment it hit his stick, he was directing it towards goaltender Riles. Stadler, along with Anderson and Hoff up front. And they've got Carpenter laying back on the blue line with Tekin in, and the Rails win the draw. Out to center. Here they come. Meineheim busts between two defenders, feeds it to the right. Might have wanted to continue that trip right to the net. Now back to behind Brecken Ross. Here's Ross turning away from the checkers. Goes back to behind. Brecken Ross playing the far side, a year younger than Tanner. Right point to the left point with Pavlovich giving it. And out to center ice and having to chase the puck back into their own zone with the Pavlovich sending it ahead on the right. Pavlovich's pass on the right through the circle. A shot. Oh, and that's in wide. Tip to the front. Some open net. That closed up in a hurry. Brecken Ross lost it to the near boards and out to center comes North Shore. On the feed to the line for Anderson, and the play is whistled down offside. Still amazed, having been away from the high school game, seeing Kevin Morrison. Not that I think he's too old, I'm just amazed he has stayed with it so long. And there are a lot before him who did the same thing, and it's fantastic. We need officials. It would not be a fun game to play without officials. Now the pass at center. Davidson stick had sent it to the blue line. It's just inside the line. On the right side, Meineheim. Poke checked off his stick. Meineheim will get it back at the blue line. Shot to the net right on. Digging away in front was Davidson. Over on the far boards, fed back right point with a drive by Cooper Johnson to right on, and that's caught chest high and kept by Bentler. Johnson 40-20. Rails leading 3-0. No scoring here in the third. North Shore's been very, very disciplined. Puck comes back. Play to the near side, Gavin Davidson had worked the pass down low beneath the circle, but we got a whistle. And apparently we're going to get a penalty. And the Rails will be penalized. Wyatt Meineheim, and it is Wyatt this time. Time of the penalty is 4:41. We'll catch Mark Fleischer's call here in a moment.
Might have been called on the Rails, number 20, Wyatt Meineheim. That penalty for interference. Meineheim interference. That penalty comes at 4:41.
Power play hockey for the Shore. They need a power play here. They need a goal. They're down by 3-0 here in the third. Down the far wall for Anderson. Back to the left point for Stadler. Anderson, far side, sends it to the net. They score on a deflection, and North Shore has cut the margin to 3-1. Well, that's exactly what they needed. Ethan Meeks is going to get the goal. Ethan Meeks scores for the Storm, and it's a 3-1 game at 5:10. A couple of power play goals in the game, one for each team. Tanner Ross on with Austin Bryant. And Wynn Giswold.
Goal for North Shore was number 11, Ethan Meeks. He got an assist from number 8, Cole Anderson, and number 28, Jake Stadler. That's Meeks from Anderson and Stadler. That power play goal comes at 5:10 of period 3.
Face off at the center zone on an infraction. Let's see, Sean Lundgren. Not quite sure what he was motioning out on the ice, whether it was to his team or the officials. Now the Rails, Pavlovich in his own end. Pavlovich
Sent near side, out to neutral, right up the middle, and that'll go all the way for icing. It finally made its way. We got a face-off in the rails end. Pavlich really, that name, I don't know why it's stymied me here a few times, more than a few times tonight. Pretty hard to stymie his play, man. He's a good-looking player. Here's Davidson. He'll face it off with Althaus. In the rail zone, 3-1. North Shore with a little momentum, perhaps, certainly incentive. Now the rails in their own end with Cooper Johnson. Here's Johnson giving ahead of the right. And that's on the backside of Brecken Ross. And will it go the distance? They'll bang each other on the end board. No icing on the play. Being played in the far corner. Davidson checking along with Althaus. Puck comes free into the circle. Picked up by the Storm. They'll carry ahead with Carpenter to center. Here's Carpenter in on the left in the far wing. He overskates and leaves the puck. Cooper Johnson's pass rink wide. And that'll go back into the zone. They'll wave icing. Goaltender Bentler had given it to his defenseman. Played in the right along the near boards, but not quick enough. Kept in by the rails from the left point by the defenseman. Anala, and it'll come up the far side, and Johnson, Cooper Johnson, near side of the pass at the blue line. Meinerheim giving it, and that was for Davidson. And North Shore will turn it back the other way, and a pass out to center for Hoff. Now backhanded by the rails defenseman Johnson. Back in their own end, being played by Tekin in North Shore. Far side on the pass, fired out to center. It goes off the stick of Cole Anderson deep into the zone. Played by Riles out to center for Meinerheim. Here's Meinerheim in on the left. Meinerheim puts a shot to the net right on. Save made by Bentler. It's played near corner. Back to the left point. Kept in with a shot. That sent wide by the stick of Oaksted. Half boards to the right point with a shot. And that one misses the net. Near circle. Banged off the boards by North Shore. Loose puck into the zone on the right. Chased down. Closing shot. And getting a stick on that. Deflecting it to the far side as Ryals. And it was the goal scorer, Meeks, with the rush into the zone on a pass up the near wing. Meeks will keep it in. He'll send it down low. Back into behind. Now over to the far side in the corner. Being checked is Carter. Reversing direction and making the pass, Pavlich. They'll pass out to center. It'll go through to the far wing and sent in deep. Boysen going after it. He along with another 17, Cam Peterson. Kept in by the rails, left side, Anala to the top of the circle, pass to the front, missing on the tip was Tanner Ross. Now back to the right point with the drive, right on. That'll climb the stick of the goaltender, Bentler. It comes back down and he covers it quickly and gets a whistle. 9:09 here in the third, 3-1 with the rails leading. 42-22 the shots as you can see. Now the rails keeping the puck in the zone with a shot that's delivered wide, put back into behind by Anala. Boost to the bottom of the circle, pass back to the right point. Cooper Johnson a shot, that's off a rail stick, picked up, trying to pass it out to neutral as Anderson does, send in on the right, Stadler going after it. Stadler along with the Cooper Johnson, end board, play for the rails, or rather North Shore, near board, taking the shot, Tekin in on the pass from Cole Anderson. Here's Tekin in again. He'll send it to the far corner. Stadler was to play it from the corner, but he was covered. Now the rails will put it behind Tanner Ross. He'll send it around the end board to the near side. And the rails able to clear. They'll send it down. And let's see if we get icing on this, and we will, with 8:19 remaining here in the third in a 3-1 game. I want to thank Terry Dunbar for joining us during the first intermission, and Nate Regas during the second intermission. Nate, a very, very likable man. He'd be 50 years ago, fun for him to spend time with me. How about that? Now back behind the goal, around to the near side. Rails with the puck trying to come out. Up the near wing, along the boards, and checked along the boards was Brecken Ross on a pretty good check. At least took him off the puck, Braylon Hoff. Pinching in deep on the near side, sent down low on the end board beneath the extended goal line, played around in behind the net, centered to the front, broken up by the defenseman in front. Nice play by Cade Peterson.
They'll take and put it back in behind the goal. The rails will. Tiekkanen has it. Here's Tiekkanen now. His pass out blocked. Loose to the circle. Picked up. Back in behind. Ross tried to put it to the front. Yeah. They score! From the far circle. On a wicked shot by Meinahein. It's his third of the game. He's got the hat trick. Oh, that's 19. Is it 19? Dylan Davidson. Man alive, Dylan. I'm sorry I spoiled you. Or was it? Oh, I'm second guessing. No, that's a hat trick. That's a hat trick. I should know better. You don't throw hats on for one goal. Called it right the first time. 20 and 19. They'll have to change the numbers for me the next time. Meinahein, no doubt. And he does it. And 9:25. He is a sniper. Ross assisting. That puck deflected out. We'll get a face off, and Bentler's right. They get that goal back now and regain the three-goal advantage. 4-1 score. 44-23 the shots. 4-1 lead. 7:18 remaining. Back to the left point. Handle up for Cooper Johnson. He looked up. Puck off a stick. Sent down low. Back into behind. Tip to the front. There's a stick paddle and a good job defensively in front, lifting the stick of the rails. Kellen Towers, defenseman Tucker Cook. He played that like a good defenseman should. Got that stick off the ice and wouldn't let Towers get it back down. Rails have done a great job in digging the puck loose around the side of the net, back into behind and getting it to the front in a good position. Now Boysen in the slot has it checked away by Althaus. They can't keep it in. Sent back into the zone. Rails tag up. Now the long rink-wide pass intercepted by Anila. And put into the zone and right back out. Rails hockey tonight on Rails TV.
Great play. Great play.
Rails hockey brought to you by Audiology Concepts, Superior, Duluth, Grand Rapids, Forest Lake, Cambridge, Edina, and Burnsville. Centered, Stadler, he'll tip it wide to the near corner. On the near side boards of the rails and the outlet pass. Here they come to center with Giswold widening out. Here's Giswold with an angle shot off the side of the net, goes after it, he gets it. On the near boards, half boards, tried to angle the pass to the right point for Pavlich. It comes up to neutral ice and then fired right back in from behind the net. Taken in. Oh, man, he tried to give it to the left, and that was picked up off the stick of the intended receiver. That pass was intended for Carpenter, and a really nice job by the stick of Giswold. He's had a good shift. They'll change lines. Come on with Dylan Densler, Caleb Lanthier, and they've also got Avery Lee. 6:01 remaining with a 4-1 lead. Dylan Densler, he'll draw it off here along with Kate Peterson. And now we've got a timeout called by North Shore. They've got 6 minutes left. I wonder if they can't certainly pull the goaltender right now, down by three. The faceoff is in their own zone. Little surprised that the draw, or rather the timeout is called, but also too, they don't want to give one up. Hockey playoff time, and boy, we got the hockey playoff weather. Beautiful day today. I think it, I don't know if it hit 50, but I did see 49 in the car while driving today on some business. And the sun was out, the sky was blue. Now I love hockey playoff weather, but to get this in February, crazy, but good. Steve Jezerski with you. Yes, I did graduate from Proctor, 1972. 50th class reunion was 2 summers ago at Buffalo House, and we had a nice crowd, actually, out of a class of about 220. I want to say we had 150 or 60 people there, which is unbelievable. We had lost upwards of 50 from the class. And we had a very nice showing. And it was good to see people, no question about it. There's a few people that I connect with. In fact, I stopped and saw Dick Carey, and you can guess where. That was 2 weekends ago and had a great visit. Dick always treats me well when I'm there. And, of course, Cookie is his wife and a Proctor grad, and wonderful people. I mentioned earlier previous goaltenders, Gary Warren. We rode the same school bus. I went to school at Munger in sixth grade, and Gary was on that bus. Tom McLeod, the great football player, NFLer, Green Bay Packer, he rode the bus. What a nice, just really a nice, nice young man. He treated everybody with respect. And that's what I remember. Terry Eggerdahl was a classmate, treated everyone with respect. Here's the Rails with a 4-1 lead, back to the right point. Given to the circle, it's caught up and out to neutral ice. Skating over to the near side, Gavin Davidson gives it on the left, and taken off the puck was Bryant. I'm wondering if Austin Bryant is not. We've got a slashing penalty coming up of Austin Bryant. I did not, just because of the other commitments I had today, was unable to get here and really do some checking I wanted to do. But is Austin Bryant, I don't know if he's a grandson or something of Greg Bryant, who I graduated with, and I think Greg played hockey, if I'm not mistaken. Kerry Gilderman from my class played back in the day. Mike Messenberg. And Bill McGann was the coach. And yeah, I really like Bill. Nice man. Out at center. North Shore trying to bring it in. Give it across on the left. There's a shot. And a glove save. And I think Cade Norman was hoping he had something there. This team has a power play. They're down 4-1. We have 5:26 remaining. And so here's their opportunity to cut that margin to 2 once again. Right point, played by Carpenters, trying to give it across on the far side, left for Stadler, back to the left point. Anderson sends a high shot. They got deflected to the back wall. Stadler wearing the C, plays it on the half board, sends it to the net with a quick shot right on, and Riles will catch that waist high and keep it. No doubt though, basketball was king when I was at the school. Terry Eggerdahl and Jim Masterson and Blaine Mukula and Dave Leonardson, Freddie Allen, Dick Sarlo, the coach. That's a while back. Out at center. Now brought in with an open net, a shoots, he scores! It's 5-1. The net was empty, they pulled the goalie. And sniping, Tanner Ross, he's a dandy. I think what's impressed me about the Rails and their goal scorers and such, they can all shoot, and then they don't miss the net. Unassisted goal for Tanner Ross. A backhand from behind in the Proctor end, and Riles making the save into keeping. Move from the end board from back into behind the net to the front by Weirman. You can attempt 100 shots a game, but if you only put 20 on net. Riles seemed to hit the net at least tonight. Now for the faceoff, the Rails have control in their own zone, leading 5-1. Clock moving with 4:25 left here in the game. Pass out to center, comes off of Tikkanen. Puck just inside the Rails line and then lifted out of there, sent all the way down. It had to be stopped by Bentler, and bearing down on him was Breckenross. Carter's line comes on. He's got Towers on one wing. They're still killing a penalty, so they're going to penalty kill. Towers up front with Ethan Carter back of the blue line. They've got Oakstead as Brecklin has to catch another puck, keep another puck, and force a faceoff. Pavlovich. Pavlovich along with Oakstead. They partner well on that blue line. Now North Shore coming out to center with Norman. Here's Norman, high, high slot with a shot, and that's cleared out on the save made. The blocker saved by Riles. Hit the netting apparently above the glass, if there's netting up there. It did not go out, so there's got to be netting. Rink is beautiful. The glass is high. In the corner, maneuvering, lifting this one up and over and into the crowd. There was no net to stop that one, I'll tell you. That was Ethan Carter. Ethan Carter and Stadler. Jake Stadler, you can see the skill in that man, that young man. Now right side on the pass. Peterson. That's Cam, gives it down low to Stadler, to Peterson. Peterson shooting, blocked at point blank by Carter. Now for the near board, sent across the goal mouth to the far side, skating to it. There's Towers, sends it up the right side into the zone. Carter fires a shot. He got that away, and I'll tell you what, that was not easy because Norman was kind of draped on him. In on the right, down the other side. Peterson goes after it, poke checked away in the end board. Ross. They'll give it up to center. Bryant going cross rank for Tanner Ross. Here's Ross in on the right. He's got a man going to the net. There's the feed. It comes through to the near side. It was Giswold, back to the center. Blue line, causing a loose puck into the zone on a breakaway. Closing. Oh, man, chopping from behind. They're going to get him for a slash, I think, and it's Austin Bryant. And it is a slash. Well, he did hack. I didn't think he had, I don't know. I don't know what I thought. I was thinking it was a pretty good play, but no doubt it was a slashing motion, so it had to be a slash. Trying to buy the poor guy a break here. Austin Bryant. Perhaps saved a goal, but you know who you have back there defending, so the goaltender, A.J. Riles. I would have liked to have seen the one-on-one. Power play again for North Shore. They do have a power play goal, each team with the one in this game. Rails have taken 5 penalties. They've killed all but one, although we had offsetting minors earlier into the zone on the right, and that shot is deflected, and that does catch netting up above the glass back in or behind the net. 2:41 left in this one. It'll take one heck of a comeback here for North Shore. They've got that ride back tonight. I'd rather take it here in the daytime. It's a beautiful ride in the daytime. At night, you don't know what you're seeing. It used to be when you made that trip up there, you didn't want to know what you were seeing. Right on the edge of the lake. But then they put those tunnels in, and it's a great trip. Sent deep into the rail zone, played around the far side. Anderson, that's Cole Anderson. Good player, sends it back along the boards for Altel's half boards to Cole Anderson turning on the far wall. Here's Cole, sends it across near side with a shot right on. A.J. Ryle anticipating, moving from right to left. He knew where that puck was going. Off the near boards, Alto shot right on. That's a shoulder save. It's played to the near wall. Now back to the right point, maybe more so his elbow on that save. Sent down to the far side boards. Anderson back to Stadler. Stadler cranks it up. Glove save, A.J. He'll keep it. We'll get a faceoff. Well, I appreciate the opportunity being here tonight. This has been great. I heard the school song when they came out tonight, and that was fantastic. On the draw, the puck goes back into behind, around to the near side. The rails will clear it down. We've got 57 seconds remaining on their kill. 1:50 here in the hockey game, with the Saints leading 5-1. Three goals from Mr. Meinerhine tonight. Brecken Ross has a goal, and Nolan Ross has a goal. So the brothers go home, will go home tonight, happy, no bragging rights. Given along the near wall, it goes into the corner in the rail zone. Power play hockey for North Shore. Stadler cranks up and right off the edge of the heel of his stick and ended up going between his skates. Now around to the near side, North Shore and Meeks. He's got their lone goal. Ethan Meeks, puck comes out to neutral ice. Minute 5 remaining, 10 seconds on the kill. And the rails will take and send one in deep. Brecken Ross sends it in on the penalty kill. And both teams at full strength are under a minute remaining of the game. We'll wrap up things quickly here tonight. Knowing that the rails are moving on, they'll play in all likelihood. The incredible surprise if it's not in Hermantown. That's who their bracket. They're bracketed with, and you expect Hermantown to win tonight, and that will be Saturday night at Hermantown. 2-1 game here earlier this season. AJ was great in that one. The Rails did all sorts of good things in that game. I think probably drew a lot of confidence, and it should be a fun one on Saturday evening. 19 seconds remaining as the Rails try to play out the clock here. Pavlovich sends it around to the far side, give it ahead along the far wing. Fanning on a shot, trying to get that off, was Weirman. There's a puck to the net, and the save is made. 51-32, they narrow the margin on shots. The Rails win it 5-1. They are moving on in the Section 7 single-A playoffs. They win for the 19th time this season. They go to 19-7. North Shore, they ended their season at 12-11-3. Sean Lundgren, I'm sure, proud of his team. Certainly proud of their effort here tonight. They put 32 shots on net, 15 just 12 days ago against the same team here in this building. And definitely made. They made a game of it here tonight. Brecklin outstanding at a goal. 5 goals and 46 shots, although that was an open netter. That was an open netter, that last goal. Hat trick tonight for Meinerhine. Single goals from Brecken Ross and Tanner Ross. And so a 5-1 victory for the Proctor Rails. I want to thank everyone for allowing me to be here, and we'll do it again if the opportunity comes up. Rails win, they move on. Follow them on Saturday night in the Section 7A semifinals. Steve Jazurski bidding you farewell. You have been watching Rails Hockey on Rails TV. Good night.
Proctor's Reed Foundation was established to enable life-enriching academic, art, and athletic activities which cannot rely on traditional funding in the Proctor School District communities. Reed has provided grants for the Imagination Library, numerous sports teams, Rails TV, A Night to Shine, the Playground for Everybody, and most recently, Reed helped the Proctor Fire Department invest in life-saving handheld thermal devices. Visit REA3D.org to learn more about how you can support Reed and help your community.
I choose Heritage Window and Door because of their reputation and because of their renewal Anderson windows that they have. And their workmanship was fantastic.
I'm so impressed.
Your home is your largest investment. Don't waste your money on cheaper windows. These are the best. It's my money, and I'm going to spend it where it's going to do me the best good, and it happened to be Heritage Window and Door.
They really know how to treat a customer.
This has been an excellent experience.
We're at a crossroads. From time to time, a section of rail needs repair. But that doesn't mean the whole line needs replacement. The same way being proud of your history doesn't mean you're stuck in the past. No, we're not stuck. We hear the whistle blowing and we're inspired. Inspired by the legacy of the people who transformed this terrain into a rail yard that supplied America with the ore needed to win world wars. We're inspired by our unshakable identity, hanging tight, like David facing down Goliaths. And we're moved by stories of our community's kindness. No matter who needs help, neighbors pitch in and get the job done. Hushed and humbled are more at play than pontification, but don't for one second think that means Proctor is a simple small town. It was built as a company town, and it continues down the tracks of time. And this rail revival is our destination.